नमस्कार दोस्तों, आर टुडेज टॉपिक इज चार्ल्स लॉ. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू चार्ल्स लॉ, व्हेन प्रेशर इज कांस्टेंट एंड वी इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर, सो व्हाट वुड हैपन टू वॉल्यूम? यू नो, वी कीप द प्रेशर कांस्टेंट. लेट अस टेक दिस कंटेनर. वी कीप द प्रेशर कांस्टेंट. So when we increase the temperature inside the container, you know, pressure increases. But to keep the pressure constant, we have to increase the volume. So in this way, volume will increase on increasing temperature. So this is called Charle's law. So that means, according to Charle's law, at constant pressure for fixed amount of gas, volume of the gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature or temperature in Kelvin. That means volume is proportional to T. That implies volume is equal to K into T. And if we plot a graph between V versus T, you know, there is a direct relation between volume and temperature. So it is a straight line passing through origin. And this graph, as this graph is at constant pressure, this is called isobar. This graph is called isobar. If we have different pressures and we plot graph, these are three isobars. At different pressures, let us take it P1, P2 and P3. So just predict what is the relation between P1, P2 and P3. Do it. To do this type of relation, well, now we have three variables. See, volume, temperature and pressure. So to get the relation between pressures, we have to keep one of the variable constant, either volume or temperature. Let us take temperature as constant. If we keep the temperature constant at pressure P3, volume is V3. At pressure P2, volume is V2. At pressure P1, volume is V1. So you can easily see the relation between V1, V2 and V3. You know, V1 is greater than V2 is greater than V3. Now, as we keep the temperature constant, and you know, at constant temperature for the fixed amount of gas, volume is inversely proportional to pressure, and that is called Boyle's law. So relation becomes P1 is less than P2 is less than P3. So this is the relation between pressures. Now let us convert this temperature in Kelvin into degree Celsius. You know, T Kelvin equal to T degree Celsius plus 273, or specifically 273.15. That means volume at temperature T is equal to K into T plus 273, T in Kelvin into T in degree Celsius. So that implies at 0 degree Celsius, so Vt becomes V0 and K into 273. That means become 273 into K. So K is equal to V0 over 273. just put the value of k here, we get Vt equal to V naught by 273 T plus 273. So means Vt equal to T by 273 into V naught plus V naught. Now you can see, if T equal to minus 273 degrees Celsius, then Vt is equal to, this is minus 273 divided by 273 minus V naught plus V naught, means Vt becomes 0. That means volume of the gas is 0 at minus 273 degrees Celsius, and this is also known as 0 Kelvin. And this 0 Kelvin is called absolute 0 because volume of the gas is 0 at this temperature. That means there is no gas at this temperature, or we can say gas is converted into liquid before this temperature. So this is actually hypothetical temperature which cannot be attained. So just plot the graph between volume and temperature, temperature in degree Celsius versus Vt. So if you plot the graph, you know, when temperature is 0 degree Celsius, Vt become equal to V naught. So that implies this is V naught. So when temperature increases above, it increases, and when we decrease the temperature below 0 degree Celsius, let us extrapolate, it touches this axis at minus 273 degrees Celsius. And you know, this is the temperature that is called absolute zero, because at this temperature volume of the gas is zero. That means there is no gas at this temperature. If T equal to 1 degree Celsius, then Vt becomes equal to V naught plus 1 upon 273 times of V naught. And if T equal to minus 1 degree Celsius, then Vt equal to V naught minus 1 upon 273 times V naught. So we can define Charle's law in this way, that for every 1 degree Celsius rise or 1 degree Celsius fall in temperature, volume of the gas is increased by 1 upon 273 times or decreased by 273 times of the volume of the gas at 0 degree Celsius. So this is the alternative definition. If at constant pressure for fixed amount of gas, volume of the gas increases or decreases by 1 upon 273 of its volume at 0 degree Celsius. For every 1 degree Celsius rise or 1 degree Celsius fall in temperature. Now, practical application of Charle's law. This is application of the Charle's law. You know, when we heat the gas, its volume increases. So when, because we heat it in the atmosphere, and in atmosphere pressure is constant. So when that gas expands, volume increases, mass is fixed. So mass per unit volume decreases. That's why hot air is less dense than the cold air. So hot air balloon rise up by displacing the cooler air of the atmosphere. So this is one of the application of Charle's law. Thank you very much for watching this video. Do like, subscribe and share my channel if you have not yet subscribed, and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. God bless you all. Happy learning.